Hey everybody, in this video we'll take a look at another method you can use for transferring an image. This is the method that I generally prefer to use most of the time because it's usually a lot faster depending on what you're painting, and that is to simply sketch it directly onto the surface. So let's dive in. I've mentioned in some of my previous videos that improving your drawing skills will in turn improve your painting skills, and I stand by that statement. Improving your drawing will absolutely improve your painting skills, and this is a very simple, easy method that you can work on to improve your own drawing skills. I'll go ahead and put up the reference image so you can see exactly what I'm doing. As you can see, it's just a skull. Now there's a lot of detail in the reference image. You'll see I am not going to put hardly any detail in this actual sketch. For me personally, I prefer just a very rough outline. I'm looking for guidelines, a roadmap if you will, before I begin the painting process. We're all a little bit different depending on your skill level, where you're at in this journey. You may prefer a more refined or adding more detail into your sketch, and that's perfectly fine. Do what works for you. As you progress, as your skills improve, you'll probably reach a point where you don't need as many of those reference lines before you actually begin the painting process. I'm just using a number 2 pencil here. It's nothing fancy, and again, this looks very rough. And it will look very rough even in the end before I begin painting it, because that's all I need. Again, your situation may be different. Use what works for you. I'm trying to keep the sketch pretty light at this point. You'll see as we progress that I start darkening some of these areas up as I start refining some of these lines. And that's okay. We can come back in and lighten those areas up when needed. Nice thing about a sketch and keeping your lines relatively light is you can erase them when you make mistakes or want to make a change. I used a kneaded eraser throughout this process. I like the kneaded erasers because they don't leave a lot of eraser shavings on your painting surface. They're very clean, and as you can see, it erased those sketch lines relatively easily. Again, this is very rough. It's not refined in any way. I'm not going to add a lot of detail. Again, a lot of detail is in the reference image, and we will incorporate all of that detail when we actually begin the painting process. But for me personally, I really don't need all of the detail in the sketch. I just need a good outline, a good roadmap for the painting process. And you'll see me make small adjustments by erasing lines and moving lines ever so slightly throughout this process. And that's one thing to keep in mind when you're doing something like this. The reference image that I'm using, it looks like it was probably somebody else's work. It's another artist had rendered this out. It's an image that I just pulled off of the internet. But use your artistic license. Just because you're using a reference doesn't mean that you have to paint it exactly like you see it in the reference. There are some things that I'm going to wind up changing on this skull just because I think it looks more appealing as far as the eye is concerned. For example, that cheekbone that you see poking out at the bottom of the nose socket, it would be the right cheekbone on the skull. In the end, I wound up omitting that completely because I thought it looked more appealing without it there. I'm also not putting in the bottom portion of the jaw because obviously I'd be running out of paper if I did. So you can make changes however you see fit to your artwork. You're not locked in stone just because you're using a reference. Now I've moved up to that deep shadowed area below the eye socket there. Again, just very vague Not a lot of detail here. Just some vague reference lines is all I'm looking for. I'll kind of sketch in that crack on the right side of that eye socket. Working on the top of the eye socket now and moving down to the bottom of the jawbone. Again, very rough. I'm not making a continuous line. I'm making a series of very small lines and sometimes dots. Just a rough guideline of where things are going to be. A lot of the reason why I do that is because this is a sketch. I'm not tracing the image. I didn't project the image. I'm sketching it directly onto the surface that I'm going to be painting. So regardless of how good you are, you're not always going to be 100% correct when it comes to proportion and where things land. Sometimes you're going to have to make corrections. And again, that's why this is a great way to improve your own drawing skills, because this is giving you the practice at doing that. Now you'll probably notice that I'm starting to get a little bit darker with some of these pencil lines, a little bit darker than I would prefer to. Now I'm going to be painting this a lot like the reference. It will be a black and white image, so I wasn't extremely concerned about getting dark, but this is a little bit darker than I would normally like to go. And again, we'll come back in and adjust that before I call this sketch finished and it's actually ready to be painted. Same thing with the teeth here as far as artistic license is concerned. I'm not necessarily trying to sketch out these teeth exactly like I see them in the reference. They will be a little bit more jaggedy. And that was just my own personal preference. Marking a few of the shadows above the teeth. Again, just simple guidelines is all I want here. I don't want to spend hours on a drawing that I'm also going to spend hours painting. And the proportion may not be 100% correct in my sketch as compared to the reference, and that's okay. It's going to be close enough. Again, use that artistic license. Now this area where I'm kind of working on some teeth back in here, a lot of this will wind up being not visible in the end because this area will be in a lot more shadow than it actually is in the reference in my painting. But it's still a good idea to sketch them in somewhat, because at this point I wasn't sure how much was actually going to show when the painting was finished. And you see me making another correction on the top of that eye socket. I decided to bring it up a little bit higher. And that's pretty much about all I'm going to do as far as the sketch is concerned. So again, you can see there's very little detail on this. It's just a rough outline, sort of a roadmap for me to begin the painting process. And your situation may be different. You may prefer a little bit more of a refined drawing and adding some more detail. That's great. use what works for you. And now I'm coming in with the kneaded eraser once again to start lightening some of these darker lines that I've put into the sketch. And all I'm doing is pressing the kneaded eraser onto the surface and then lifting the eraser back up, and that pulls some of the lead off of the canvas and into the eraser. It does a great job of lightening your pencil lines. I apologize. I didn't have a lot of time to put together a video for you guys this week due to some other circumstances that were beyond my control, but I hope you guys have got something out of this. If you did, remember to like, subscribe, and share. I'm Trevor with Wicked Art Studio, and I'll see you guys next time.